Thai, sisters and brothers, thank you for being here. It is no exaggeration to say that we are at one of the most dramatic turning points in the history of global capitalism. Everywhere, the old social and political order is fragmenting, and a new generation is rising up to demand a different world. And here in the United States, in the belly of the beast, the two-party system is facing an almost unprecedented crisis of legitimacy. Because think about it, for over 150 years, the American ruling class has boasted the most stable capitalist political system. They used to call it the greatest democracy in the world. And historically, the Democrats and Republicans were two of the most powerful and reliable instruments of the capitalist class, deeply integrated into the imperial state machinery that has dominated and exploited the entire world for generations. But after presiding over three decades of rising inequality and social decay in the face of the deepest crisis of world capitalism since the 1930s, my sisters and brothers, all of that is unraveling. On the one hand, the degeneration of the old Republican big business leadership has reached such a level of corruption that even a right populist blowhard like Donald Trump can swoop in and with one blow knock their crumbling edifice down. And on the other hand, while Clinton narrowly prevailed over Sanders in the primary, this was only accomplished at the expense of exposing the deeply undemocratic machinery of the Democratic Party primaries. It was only accomplished at the expense of exposing the naked bias of corporate media, and at the expense of further exposing Wall Street's stranglehold over American politics. Hillary Clinton may have survived the primary battle, but the neoliberal clique of the New Democrats that have dominated that party since Bill Clinton's 1992 victory are starting to lose the war. Hillary has emerged as the least trusted, least popular major party candidate in modern history, with only Trump trumping her in her historic unfavorability ratings. Bernie's political revolution has aroused millions to the potential for a completely different kind of politics. Millions now see that it is possible, without making a dime of corporate cash, for a truly people-powered political movement to challenge the corporate establishment for power. The idea that there is no alternative to capitalism, and by the way, do you know who coined that phrase? Margaret Thatcher. The idea that there is no alternative to capitalism, that this system is invincible, that idea has gone. And now the specter of socialism has returned with a new generation discussing a socialist-inspired vision for transforming society. The idea of building a broad new political party to unite the 99% against the corporate duopoly is also rapidly gaining popularity. Historians may look back at the Sanders campaign and at 2016, the year in general, as a turning point in US politics, as the beginning of the end of the US two-party system. And we are all movement, but sisters and brothers, nothing is automatic. Our movement at a very definite crossroads. A debate has been raging among Bernie's Sandinistas over whether to follow Bernie into the Democratic Party to attempt a transformation from within, or to back Green Party candidate Jill Stein and continue by building an independent mass movement for a political alternative. We in Socialist Alternative supported Bernie's campaign from the beginning, but we made no secret that we had fundamental disagreements with Sanders, especially on his decision, as Jill Stein has so eloquently put it, to attempt a political revolution from within a counter-revolutionary party. And as everyone knows, Sanders has just endorsed Hillary Clinton on Tuesday at her rally in New Hampshire. Emotions are running high, and we need to have respectful discussions in the coming days. We need to have a patient, understanding approach with people who have strong personal attachments to Sanders, and also with those who say they will be voting for Clinton to stop Trump. In some cases, we will have to respectfully agree to disagree and continue the discussion later. But we also need to call things by their real names and not gloss over what has happened. We should be clear, what Sanders has done by endorsing Clinton is not just a tactic or not merely a mistake. Whatever his intentions, by endorsing a candidate of Wall Street, by backing a party controlled by big business, Sanders has abandoned our revolution. He has endorsed the epitome of neoliberal politics in Hillary Clinton. By doing so, he is attempting to turn his political revolution into its opposite. He is now using his considerable authority with tens of millions of people to funnel them back into the corporate Democratic Party and attempting to surrender our movement to the same establishment that we have been fighting against. Millions of Sanders supporters, nearly half in some polls, say they will not vote for Clinton. Bernie has correctly and repeatedly said, not me, us, but by endorsing Clinton, he has forgotten that message. Our movement had no say in this. Sanders refused to even meet with Jill Stein. He refused to even organize a real debate within the movement. We recognize the historic success of his campaign so far, and he himself has played no small role in that. But we cannot confuse the individual with the movement. It is time for our movement to move on. Into the lair of Wall Street and the billionaire class. As recent polls confirm, the Democratic Party has consciously chosen to not back the strongest campaign against Donald Trump. The latest polling shows Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump tied, deadlocked in the polls. This is an early reading, admittedly, things could change, but it is revealing, nonetheless, of just how fiercely the Democratic Party opposes our grassroots movement, that they would choose this weak, corrupt candidate, Hillary Clinton, as an opponent against Donald Trump. While Sanders has again and again shown that he could trounce Trump in November. But this is not accidental. The Democratic Party and its billionaire backers are quite simply more afraid of our political revolution than they are of Trump. grow, and we are prepared to risk a right-wing racist president. But if that happens, let us be clear, this is on them. Sanders also says he supports Clinton because he wants to defeat Trump. Well, there can be no doubt about Bernie's diagnosis of the threat represented by Trump's right-wing populism. He is entirely wrong about how to cure the disease. We will not succeed in decisively defeating the right by supporting establishment politicians like Hillary Clinton. It is a massive outrage at the brutal big business policies carried out by the political establishment that has created the basis for Trump's ascendancy in the first place. We saw this very clearly. Trump is not the first phenomenon. We saw this clearly a few years ago when we witnessed the rise of the Tea Party, which was born out of the fury at the Wall Street bailouts, while the left was busy making excuses for Obama's pro-corporate policies. Socialist Alternative and I are endorsing Green Party candidate Jill Stein for president. Jill is fighting on essentially all the same issues that brought millions around Bernie. She is calling for Medicare for All, a $15 minimum wage nationally, and an end to mass incarceration, as you heard her say. There can be no doubt in our minds at this moment that Jill's campaign is the clear continuation of our political revolution and deserves the broadest possible support from all of us. Have begun a campaign of fear against our call for a left-wing political alternative by preemptively blaming us for the threat of a Trump presidency. Just like they tried to blame the 3 million people who voted for Ralph Nader in 2000 for George Bush's presidency and the invasion of Iraq. But, sisters and brothers, we know the truth. It was the brutal neoliberal politics of Bill Clinton and the New Democrats that cost Al Gore the presidency. Yeah. It was the complicity of the whole Democratic Party, including Hillary Clinton, that paved the way for the bloody invasion and occupation of Iraq. First, they rigged the electoral system against any anti-establishment working class challenge to the capitalist parties. Then, they blame working people for voting wrong when the Republicans win in this warped electoral system. First, the Democratic Party embraces an agenda of deregulating Wall Street, of endless war, of free trade disasters, of budget cuts, and union busting, of mass incarceration and structural racism. Then they blame working people they have ruthlessly betrayed for refusing to vote again for their false promises. It is not we who are responsible for the rise of right-wing populism, for the racist and anti-immigrant appeal of Donald Trump. It is the neoliberal pro-corporate policies and obvious corruption of both the Republican and Democratic parties. We have repeatedly warned, collapsing our movement behind Clinton's Wall Street campaign would not only sabotage the political revolution, it would not only mean derailing the incredible momentum we have built over the past year, but it would also help right-wing populists like Trump to gain strength. As we've already seen, if the left continues to fail to offer a fighting alternative, the mass anger fueling the global anti-establishment revolt can be channeled behind right-wing nationalist forces. Even, and this is what we should truly watch out for, even if Trump loses the election, the right-wing forces behind him will emerge strengthened, emboldened, and better organized if we do not build our movement now. We cannot let that happen. We cannot allow ourselves to be bullied into the same bankrupt, lesser evil political logic that has brought us to this moment of crisis. For the left to win the things we have all been fighting for, we will need to build a powerful mass movement based on political independence from the two parties of neoliberalism. And this year, we need to use Jill Stein's campaign and this historic moment to prepare the ground for a new mass party to unite the 99% against the 1%. Imagine the emergence of a broad movement-based political party in this country, bringing together socialists, greens, left trade unions, Black Lives Matter activists, immigrants, women's rights activists, the LGBTQ movement, environmentalists, and the millions of working people searching for a left alternative. Such a party would not just be an electoral project, but would become an organizing center. It would work with our movements, not against them. A mass party of working people, completely independent of corporate money and influence, would help raise class consciousness. It would help reinforce the idea that working people have common interests across the divides of race, national origin, and gender identity. It would also, crucially, help make clear that as working people, we have no interest in common with the billionaire class who have used our economy, politics, and even culture to meet their narrow agenda of greed and profit. A broad mass party of the 99% would create a crucial space for the left to debate the strategy and program needed to end poverty, war, racism, and environmental catastrophe, to debate whether this can even be accomplished within the framework of capitalism or whether a socialist transformation of society is needed. And within this broad party for workers, Socialist Alternative would campaign for the idea of taking the top 500 corporations under public ownership and democratic workers' control. We would campaign to replace the destructive, profit-driven capitalist economy with a democratically planned socialist economy based on the needs of humanity and the planet. One of the most important achievements of the Sanders campaign was to reopen a mass debate on socialist ideas and on how we can change society. But we have fundamental differences with Bernie on the meaning of socialism. We do not think that capitalism can be reformed. Capitalism is a system based on massive inequalities and environmental destruction. We need a society based on equality, sustainability, and solidarity. As Bernie himself said, winning a political revolution will take a movement of millions and must be about more than any single candidate or any single election. In that spirit, we say, it is time to move beyond Bernie. It is time for the movement that began this presidential campaign to learn to be independent and choose for itself a path forward. This will not happen overnight, but we also must have a sense of urgency. Movements are endangered that do not learn to walk on their own. They can be misled, they can be sold out, they can miss historic opportunities like the one we have today. Last December, Socialist Alternative and I launched Movement for Bernie to independently campaign for Sanders. While always being upfront about our differences, we recognized the huge potential of the movement behind Bernie to challenge the billionaire class. But now it is time for a new name for our new movement. We will be relaunching Movement for Bernie as Movement for the 99%. Bernie is turning toward the Democratic Party, and we, the 99%, are turning toward political independence. Mobilizing from the 120,000 people who signed our petition calling for building a political alternative to the Democrats, we organized dozens of meetings around the country, just like this one, to announce the launch of the Movement for the 99% and to discuss our next steps. And in just a few weeks, there will be mass protests outside the Democratic National Convention in Philadelphia. Socialist Alternative will be there with Movement for the 99% activists, with Jill Stein, with Bernie or Bust, and many others to demand an end to the corporate stranglehold over our democracy. We will be there calling for a vote for Stein, for launching a united mass party for the 99%, and to build support for a socialist alternative to this rotten system. And if you agree with our ideas, I hope that you will join my organization, Socialist Alternative, and I look forward to seeing you all Seattleites in Philly in a few days.